trouble for you. Gosh, I could barely imagine how frightened you must have felt. But don't worry, you'll never have to return to that dreadful place ever again. I actually managed to convince Robert to scrap the animatronics since, you know, they're not the safest thing around. It really upset him that his dream restaurant had to be shut down. Just like the first one. But, I wanted to tell you something that I discovered. I was making my way to the fun place around 6 a.m. to help load the animatronics and pack a few things. And while I was heading back to parts and service to get my tools, I came across this weird binder filled with notes. I found it stuffed in one of the animatronic heads. I took a look inside and it was full of so many god-awful plans. All about different ways to take Robert's business out. There were details and gruesome plots about killing and descriptive notes about tampering with the AI. Saying all that, I'm sure you can get a good idea of who was behind all the hell that's been bringing out here. I should have known that man wasn't right in the head. He is the reason the animatronics were acting so aggressive. That creep caused all of this. His plan was to change the AI and the animatronics, making them act aggressive. And what makes it even worse is he wanted blood. He wanted to cause suffering to not only the Grunter, but the people who supported his business. And to do so without breathing charges. Even if that meant children. But I showed Robert my discovery, and really sure he couldn't believe his own brother would do such a thing. By the time we contacted the police and showed them the evidence, George was gone. I just wanted to tell you that he's still out there, somewhere, so please,